Ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Scruffy Tam Airlines. This is Scruffy Tam, Lord of Socks, your pilot for this and several other flights as we tour the United States from East Coast to West Coast and back. I hope you enjoy these Twitch live streams that were recorded live and with my community. And I hope that you will come visit me live on twitch.tv/scruffytam sometime soon. So once again, I hope you enjoy this series. I hope you are enjoying and have enjoyed this series of flights as we tour the United States, take some time and sightsee in some of the bigger cities. And I hope to see you soon. Take care of yourselves and safe flying. Welcome to an evening stream of Flight Sim. Appreciate you being here this evening. Second stream of the day. And I hope you enjoyed the background music from a rhetorical owl who is Thomas World, a streamer who also streams Microsoft Flight Sim. And I just checked, he is number 7, ranked 7th in the world in the Reno Air Races. Really awesome streamer. Be sure to check them out if you don't already. He was kind enough to send me his CD autographed. And also I had permission. I do have permission from himself and the publisher to, or the producer, to play it live on Twitch. So no problems with DCMA strikes or anything like that. Tomos, speaking of the man Tomos, here he is right here. What's up? Hey, Tam the OG, my daughter, how are you? So it's kind of early, but let me go ahead and give Tomos a shout out. I'll have to shout Tomos out again once we get some more people in here. So y'all be sure to check out Tomos from Tomos
World.
Okay, I'm in the lead.
How am I in the lead? Oh, the guys collided. It's the last few meters, ladies and gentlemen. Woo! Did I make it?
I was there for that one. I was there for that race. Hey, and this. Then Tam the OG shouted Tomos out. So let's go ahead and watch this
one. Look at this. Tomos World, place 7 right now, 8,100 points. I am one of the best pilots. Look at this. World top 10, Tomos number 7. Boom, 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 everybody. Let's go.
There we go. So two clips for Tomos. And then here's one for Tam the OG, my daughter. Give Tam a little shout out here, and then we'll get rolling. Hope everyone's doing well. Tomos, what is it? Is it morning time for you? What? That wasn't even a clip. Let me shout Tam the OG out one more time and see what in the world. Oh, it's 1 a.m. Okay. So I guess it is morning, but super late.
Why am I a llama again? Where am I going?
Yes, so that is a shout out for Tam the OG and for Tomos World. So Tomos, have you been doing, that was Sims. That was Sims 4. Which is something I had streamed for a little while myself. I had done Sims 4 as well. Let's see if, I'm gonna go ahead and switch to Microsoft Flight Sim and hopefully the races do a little bit better than what they did. They're a little more reliable than what they were earlier today. I did 3 races, then it started crashing like crazy and I never was able to get into another race. So let's see what it's looking like. You didn't have a single crash tonight? Wow. So right after you left, Tomos, that was my last race, the race that you and I were in. And after that, it just crashed every single time. Allison, hey Allison, welcome. Oh my goodness. Y'all, if you don't follow Allison, Allison is an amazing streamer. I raided her after my morning stream, and oh my gosh, the most friendly streamer I think that I've ever raided that wasn't already a friend of our community. I'll put it that way. Just an amazing streamer. Tam the OG, if you will shout out Allison, please. Allison, welcome. Welcome to the stream. I really enjoyed your stream for the short period of time I was in there. You will be seeing me more often though, but good morning to you. So is it morning for you now, Allison? Oh, it's just got midnight. Okay, so it is 7 p.m. for me. I'm East Coast.
HG, North Europe we're playing on, but we're just coming into our final landing, which is about 6 miles away.
So there's our new friend.
But we're here every Sunday. Well, that would have been the thing. At least...
Just watching the clip.
05, Viper Strike, 05.
Awesome. So that was a short clip from Allison Johnson's stream. So Allison, do you do this every time? Like all your streams, are they historical flights? Because I really found that fascinating. That's really cool. Yes, you do. That's really, really awesome. I will be spending some time in your streams because I love history. And your stream, since you're kind of recreating historical streams, it reminds me a lot of, there's a YouTube channel called The Flight Channel, and they cover plane crashes, and it looks like they use flight sim. But anyways, I really enjoyed the time that I was there. Tam the OG, my daughter. Yeah, so Tam the OG is my daughter. She's also a streamer, and just shouted her out. So I'm gonna race in the T6 class. Let's see if it will let me. Amelia Earhart again after Christmas. See, I've always been fascinated with flight, and Amelia Earhart was one of those when I was a kid that I was just really. So there were two things when I was a kid that I was just really. Really riveted me that were in the news. One was Amelia Earhart, and the second one was Oak Island. If y'all have ever heard of Oak Island, up in somewhere way up north, where there was supposedly, Tam the OG, give me just a minute, where there was supposedly some pirate treasure buried, and for years they've been trying to figure out, you know, where it's at, and there's all sorts of, you know, rumors and theories about what's buried there, if anything. But back in the 70s, when I was a kid, it was just fascinating to think, you know, there's pirate treasure buried and all this. Nova Scotia, there you go, Allison. Thank you. So you're familiar with it. But really, really cool stuff. Okay, Tam the OG has redeemed a squid voice, so...
5 minutes of squid voice starts right now. Thank you, Tam. Let me get this race going here. And I really like this chrome livery with purple accents, purple wings, purple engine cover on the front. It's really amazing. So let's see how this works out. Hopefully it will work out better than it did this afternoon for me. Wait on the lobby to load. I'm excited and nervous. My hands got so sweaty flying this afternoon. So Allison, how long have you been streaming? How long have you been on Twitch? Let's go. I'm excited to watch. I'm excited to fly. almost dreams about Reno racing now. Alright, let's go, let's go. I can't do my announcer voice right now because Oh, wow, just since the end of January? You've done really, really well. Yeah, that's amazing. I've been streaming for a little bit over a year. And I took a hiatus in June and July of this year. I had some health issues and some other personal stuff going on, so I stopped streaming for about 2 months. And it really killed my channel. So I'm trying to get things built back up. Alright, here we go. Qualification round. Hopefully, this is where it started crashing earlier today, so hopefully that doesn't happen this time. Here we go, folks. I had a really intense race this afternoon. I finished third out of four, so I almost finished last place, but the last two laps were really, really intense. An intense fight for third place. And here we go.
We're about to be on the clock. It's time for qualifying.
Qualifying round. Find that first pylon in the start-finish line. Here we go, folks. Coming around the corner for the first lap of the qualifying round. Keep your act together. Stay focused. Oh no, I'm gonna miss it. Oh, did I make it? Is that considered a miss or no? I hope it was not. I hope that wasn't a miss. Where's the third pylon? Am I? Oh, good lord, I have totally messed up.
Get back down to race altitude.
I may as well restart this one. I have totally messed up. This is only my fourth qualification round in this rain. It's making you dizzy. It's almost. Yeah, I'm definitely not gonna tap out.
Your line's too high. Get back down to race altitude.
Oh my word, I'm doing horrible. Well, I bet you I'll be starting in last place. Yep.
That's it, folks. Qualifying is done. We're going to have a...
Oh wow, by 6 seconds. That's almost 7 seconds. Wow.
I'm almost 7 seconds behind first place. That is bad. That's bad. All right, folks, here we go. Scruffy Tam is, the race has started. Scruffy Tam in bringing up the rear of the pack after a horrible qualifying round. Hopefully, he can pick things up and get to the front of the pack. Here we go. The race will be starting soon. Coming up on the start-finish line in the first pylon in 3, 2, 1. Here we go. All right, and I'm starting out in second position. Not bad. How did I get in first? Now I'm back down to second and quickly dropping to last place. That's okay. Oh my goodness, the wake turbulence is blowing me all over the place. Just keep a tight line. There's the third pylon. Number four, yeah, I'm going too high. I don't want a altitude penalty for sure. I don't want to crash like I did this afternoon either. Go, let's do this. Fifth pylon, let's cut it. There we go, I'm getting past though. I'm in fourth place, third place. Oh no, I'm gonna miss this one. Oh, that's the first pylon I've missed. Dang it. That's a 12 second penalty for me after the race is over with. So that's gonna hurt. That's gonna hurt bad. Sam, I'm sorry. I see where you posted, but I can't look right now.
Too high,
bring it back down. There we go. I don't want a too high penalty for sure. Like I said, just trying to get back in the groove. I had a really good groove going this afternoon, and then the game started crashing. Okay, so I've got the fifth place person has also got a pylon penalty, so that's a good thing for me. I just need some other players to get pylon penalties or altitude penalties. I can't afford another pylon penalty, that's for sure. Fourth place, holding steady. Oh, $5 a pair for socks? Dang. I got a pair at Hobby Lobby yesterday. Oh, no. Dang it.
Keep it steady. Cut that pylon.
Oh, that's got me out of the groove, y'all. I am not doing good now.
Get back down now.
Hey. All right, two pylon penalties is gonna kill me. That's 24 seconds after the race is over that they're gonna penalize me. We're halfway through. Of course, I'm gonna go ahead and finish, but I'm really disappointed with those two. That's probably gonna put me in last place, but that's okay. This is a good warm up for me. And I can still overtake some of these other players. I mean, I'm not going to give up, that's for sure. I still have an opportunity to do that right there, like I just did. Cut the pylons really close and make up some lost space. See, now I'm in third. I can actually see the first place. I think that's second place right there above me, right? Yeah, so I'm really close to second place. I need to focus on myself, not the other pilots, though. That's going to be my strategy. Focus on my own flying, not where everyone else is at and what they're doing. When I focus on the other people, I'm taking my eyes off of my own line. I'm in second place. Don't crash, Scruffy. Don't crash. I don't think I'll catch Rotorhead, but I could keep the second place spot, though. Need to keep flying these tight lines around the pylons like I'm doing. I'm pretty pleased with how well I'm doing right now. I do need to get down before I get in trouble. Here we go. Don't miss pylon 7. That hurt. I went way wide on pylon 6. Excuse me. And that let someone get in front of me. Oh, Oh crap. Oh my gosh, I am not. I am so mad at myself right now.
Careful with the pylons. They'll hit you with a penalty every time. Watch your altitude. You're too high.
Well, I was doing so good, and then I turned a little too hard. I cut that pylon a little too quickly trying to go around, and I've messed that up. Excuse me. And now, if I'm not careful, I'm going to crash into the ground. And that would not be good either. That would cost me time. No, don't let that be a penalty. It's not good. That was not a penalty. I've never had a pylon penalty until this race. And now I've gotten three. Okay, climbing up. I'm in fourth place. Hold it together, Scruff. Hold it together. Let's get over on the correct side of the pylon. All right, last lap. Let's hold it together and try to get position a little bit. Let's see if I can get third at least and then see what happens with the penalties from there. I'm thankful for the dude on the radio that's telling me, you know, to watch my altitude and stuff. Yeah, Tam, this is kind of like Mario Kart, except in the air. All right, here we go. See if I can overtake. Nope. Oh, come on. It's such a tight pack. The pack is so tight right here. Not gonna happen. I'm not gonna pull off a fourth place win. Let's just be content with the fifth place. At least I'm not last. Whew, that was stressful. Hands are sweating. And there goes the final person, and I'm in last place because of my penalties. Unfortunately, y'all, the penalties cost me a couple positions, so I just need to be careful about the pylons. I've got to step away for just a minute. I'm going to take a quick bathroom break. Mrs. Scruff needs me for just a minute, and y'all, I'll be right back. Enjoy some rhetorical owl music while I'm gone. Be right back.
So deep, fortune plans to run away in my sleep. Oh, I know, just a cue, just one time that I'm sure. I'm gonna leave it all behind. I'm the mastermind of humankind.
The mastermind of humankind. The mastermind of humankind. The mastermind of humankind. The mastermind.
All right, I am back. Thank you for patiently waiting. Sorry about having to leave so suddenly. Wife was having an issue with a Christmas bracelet and was needing my help, so I helped the wife out. Tomos, thank you so much for that compliment. It'll take me a while to get the hang, especially because I consider myself still a relatively new pilot. So I'm still learning the stuff, and then racing just kind of throws a whole new element in there, but I love it. All right, let's go ahead and start another one. My worldwide ranking is nothing right now. No, it's not. Oh, see, here we go again. Dadgummit. Now, this may be because I waited too long to start back. So I'm going to go ahead and let's start a new race. Hopefully it doesn't keep crashing like it just did. If it does, I will go back to my usual coast to coast tour of the US. So we have stuff we can do regardless. But Thomas, thank you so much. I'm very happy for as little as I have flown. I've got 52 hours total of flying, so I'm pretty pleased with that. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and turn the music down and let's listen to the game. All right, folks, Scruffy Tam is back. We're going ahead and finding a race to put Scruffy Tam in. We got a really huge crowd here in Reno, Nevada today for the air races. Let's see if we can get a full lobby for this one. We're checking to see. All racers, go ahead and report to the main lobby, please. All racers, report to the main lobby. All right, and we do have Fretless 333 in an AT6D Eros ready to go. Scruffy Tam has just also signed up in his T6 Texan. Beautiful livery there with a chrome finish and purple accents. Ready to roll. Yeah, for sure. Oh, wait a minute. There. Yeah, for sure, Tomos. That's what I've got to work on is my line, flying the line. And we got a few more flyers just joined with 8 seconds left to go. On Stuff 422 in an SNG 4 Big Red. Fluff 04 in an AT6 Baron's Revenge. And Crook Alpaca 703 also in a T6 Texan. All right, qualifying round is next. This will be a one lap qualifying round. Fastest gets pole position. Let's see how Scruffy Tam will do this time. All right, here we go.
We're in for one heck of a race, but first, time to qualify.
All right, here we go, round the corner, and the start finish line will be right here at us. There's the lap line. All right, here we go. Pylon number one.
Get back down to racing altitude.
Oh no,
I am. Stay up there.
All right. Pylon 2, you really couldn't see because I was so high and wide. Pylon 3.
Get back down to racing altitude. Judges will penalize you if you stay up there.
Alright, here comes Pylon 4. Get down to the proper. Oh no! Dang it! I stayed up too high that time. right, here we go. Pylon 6, I totally overshot it, which it's not that I didn't bypass it. I just was way too wide for it. Way too wide on it. And here we go. Lap line is here. And I am in last place, but that's okay. All right, Scruffy Tam again, finishing last, but just a few tenths of a second slower than the fourth place person. So this could go pretty good. A long spread though, from 17 seconds to 26 seconds from the first place person to Scruffy Tam in last. Here we go. Go ahead and get lined up. Let's start the races in 3, 2, 1. Let's go racing. All right, here we go.
We're in first place now. Check your altitude. Get back down now. We're in first place now. You're in the lead. Let's keep it that way.
Yep, let's try to keep it that way. How about that? Right? Booyah. Where's the... Did I miss the fourth? Holy crap, I did. Dang it. Well, I totally messed that up, didn't I? Maybe I didn't mess up too bad. I'm still in third. I'll take it. Wow, how did I get so far off the line and still end up in first place, y'all? How?
You're in the lead. Let's keep it that way.
And I went from first to fourth just like that. That's okay. That's okay. Crook Alpaca looks like cut a pylon short, so they've got a penalty. That will bode well for me. As long as I don't cut a pylon, that should put me in at least fourth place. Oh man, oh, I collided with another aircraft. That is totally, that's a bunch of crap. I don't even see my next pylon. Holy crap. That collision, these collisions are really, I shouldn't say anything. I mean, if I collide in real life, I'm dead or injured or something, or lose my aircraft. So, but where's the person that I collided with? I mean, why are they not as far back as I was? It's okay. I'm not going to complain. All I can do is fly, deal with the consequences, use what little skill I have, use the skill that I have to bridge the gap, and that's all I can do. Deal with the cards I'm given. Come on, come on, come on, Scruff. There we go. I did not want to cut that pylon and go with that penalty, so okay. All right, I've got to focus again. I've got to get focused. I was doing really good until me and that other aircraft collided. So I've got to get that focus back.
Watch your altitude. You're too high.
Here we go, fourth pylon. How far away am I from the fourth place finisher? I could still pull off a fourth place finish even if I stay this far behind the pack, because Crook Alpaca is going to get a 12 second penalty for cutting the pylon short. Yeah, so I'm 4 seconds behind, so that still puts me in fourth place, but I don't want to be content with being in last place and just winning because of a penalty from another player. So I want to use my skill to win, not another player's lack of skill to win. All right, here we go. Coming up on the lap line. Let's keep it really tight, Scruff. Let's see if we can pass Crook Alpaca at least. And I think we're getting close. Yes, there they are, right there. And I have now surpassed Crook Alpaca. I am truly in fourth place now. I'm 6 seconds behind third, though, so this is going to be hard to make up, but it is doable. And all it's going to take, Crook Alpaca has something has happened. They're out, so now I am in last place. But all it's going to take is Fretless to make a mistake and cut a pylon, and that'll put me in third.
Check your altitude. Get back down now.
I'm okay. I'm going to hang with it. I'm going to stick with it. Oh, wow. I'm really close to the second place person. How? Wow. Look at this. Oh, no, 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 no. I don't want to get a pylon cut penalty, and I did not. Holy crap. There we go. There we go. There we go. All right. Get it together, Scruff. Get it together. Good job. Good job. I held it together. I didn't crash. I'm still tight with second and third place. There's still a possibility that I could overtake third place.
Keep it up.
Here we go. Let's do it. Let's do it. Keep it tight. Keep it low. Third pylon. I see the fourth pylon this time. All right, here's the fifth pylon. Watch the ground, Scruffy. Watch the ground. Yeah, that was nice. That was nice. I got really close to the ground, but that was a nice turn. Stay on the right side of those pylons, dude. I'm only, I'm right at 3 seconds behind third place. It's going to take a mistake, I think, on One Stuff's part for me to pull this off.
You can still do this.
But like the radio said, I can still do this. There's still time until the finish line comes. Until the finish line comes, anything can happen. And see? Oh my gosh, what the heck? Okay, never mind. I'm going to focus on the pylons and my abilities. I'm not going to worry about what just happened. I'm 7/10 of a second behind third place. I can do this. Banana Ice Zambi, what's going on, my friend? Here we go. We're going to... Oh, my gosh. How did I get in second? Okay, focus. Focus. Here we go. Let's do this. Let's do this. All right, here's the fifth pylon. Stay to the right side of it. Keep this up. Keep it up. Keep it up. Keep it up. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. I can do this. My first second place finish. Stay to the right side of that seven pylon. I'm making mistakes. Yes. Yes. Yes, holy crap. Holy crap. Whew. Wow. That was intense. Thank you, everybody. Thank you. Thank you, Allison. Thank you, Tomos, Dakey. Dude, I think they were. I mean, that was amazing. That was amazing. Thank you, everybody. Holy moly. I've got to get some water. Let's see. I missed some stuff here. Tomos was on the edge of his seat. Dash of Scruffy rides the train of sleds into chat. Welcome, Banana Ice Ambi. Welcome, Dakey. Good evening, my friend. Let's see here. Just catching up. Maybe changing the view to the outside of the aircraft will make it a little easier for you to see all the pylons and have a greater field of view. I may try that next time. Tomos. Oh, Allison, thank you so much. It really is an honor for me to have you spend this much time in my channel. Thank you so much. Enjoy your dreams. Have sweet dreams, friend. I appreciate you, and I shall see you on your next stream, hopefully. Thank you, Allison. I'm going to give Allison another shout out. Be sure to check out Allison. Just met her today when I raided her. Really an amazing flight sim streamer.
HG, we're, North
does
Europe
historic
we're playing
flights.
On, but we're just coming into our final landing, which is about 6 miles away. But we're here every Sunday. Well, that would have been the thing. At least 05, Viper Strike, 05.
So enjoy that clip. And I really enjoyed what little time I was able to spend in her stream. A couple more shout outs while I'm here. So Banana Ice Zambi is also a streamer and a friend of the community. Fun fact.
I just need to stand there for like.
In just a minute, I'll give you a fun fact about Banana.
Yeah, I didn't make it. Oh, God. I meant to kick it up. Kick him up, and then I spin.
All right, so Banana Ice Zambi and myself and three other streamers hit affiliate on the exact same night. We all hit affiliate the same night. So Banana Ice Zambi and I have been streaming for the same period of time. The last person I want to shout out is Dakey. My mind just went blank on me, but Dakey is a flight sim streamer also. And Dakey, you streamed for quite some time this afternoon. I did spend just a minute in your stream. But enjoy this clip from Dakey's stream. Now, oh, wow. Flying a four prop. Nice. All right, and that's all our friends. Tomos, shout out to Tomos out earlier. Also, Tomos will have, I've got a rotating shout out that I use for several of my flight sim streamer friends. But yeah, so Tomos and Banana Ice Zambi, myself, my mind just went blank, and three other streamers, we all got affiliate, and it was all due to the same person directing people to our channels to help us. So it was pretty awesome. You're welcome, Dakey. Yeah, it looks like you got a pretty good sized raid from oh shoot, I can't remember the guys. Forder Flies or Forder Heavy Noctis, you and me, so four of us. There we go. Pretty exciting. I moved up. I got 7 points this time, which probably helped me on the leaderboard, but I'm still ranked. Oh, I actually went down. Holy crap. Oh, so Forder rated Allison before, and then Allison rated you. Okay, sorry. I totally got that screwed up, didn't I? I got it backwards. All right, so I am ranked 1,816 in the world, everybody. Let's go ahead and do another race. Gosh, I'm loving this. I am loving this. The music that you're hearing is actually made by Tomos. Tomos created all of these songs, produced them, mixed them, everything. He's got a CD out on iTunes, and I have a physical signed copy of his CD by Rhetorical Owl. Man, I love those emotes. All right, let's go ahead and get back to the races here. All right, everybody. So our second place finisher, Dakey. I have not. I visited one time, and he had a bunch of people in there, and I didn't really get a chance to interact with him very much. But I will. I will.
Hello. Is it me lurking?
Oh yeah, Banana. Thank you for the lurk. I appreciate it. All right, everybody, looks like there's five contenders in this one, and the race is about to start. We're going to do the qualifying round first. It is a one lap around our track, and to see what position everyone starts in. So Scruffy Tam will start his lap momentarily. Let's see how our second place finisher in our last race does on the qualification round. All right, Thomas, I probably am gonna try the external view, but not right now. I don't know. I'm gonna do it this way again one more time, and then we'll see. Then we'll see. I'm a little bit hard-headed sometimes, Thomas. At least that's what my wife says, right? My wife says I'm hard-headed too. All right, here we go. Time starts now. Let's see what position I start in this time. Although starting position doesn't seem to matter very much. And I do see another aircraft. Does that mean that we all qualify on the same lap? I thought we all flew at different times, but I thought I saw another airplane. Oh shoot, I thought I saw another airplane ahead of me.
Your line's too high. Get back down to race altitude.
Get back down to race altitude. Yeah, I definitely don't want a penalty. There we go. Let's see if I can start out in something other than last place. I usually qualify in last place. Let's see if I can do a little bit better this time.
Careful, you're too high. If you continue like this, you'll be penalized.
I'm sure how you qualify also helps with points at the end of the race as well, so... not that there's no use in trying to qualify well. There is. All right, here we go. Let's see how I did. Hey, I'm not last. This is my first not last qualification, and I'm just 3 seconds behind first. And Scruffy Tam with his first non-last finish qualifies fourth this time. The first four. It's a really tight, only 3 second difference from first to fourth. So let's see how Scruffy Tam does this time. Here we go. The race is going to be starting soon. We'll do a 3 second countdown and then it's go time. The pilots are currently wiping their hands dry. Thank you, Tomos. Thank you, audience. 3, 2, 1. Let's go. All right, here we go. Oh, good Lord. I did see that other pilot hit me this time. That's the first time that there's been a crash and I've seen him hit me. That's really unfortunate. The good news is there's still plenty of laps to make up that crash. Plenty of time. I'm just going to focus on my own flying. Hey, CKB, welcome back, friend. Still time to, whoa, come on now. Okay, at least I didn't get the penalty. I messed up on that one. Yeah, the crashing penalty is really unfortunate. And there are some that you can avoid. There's some that you can avoid, but I mean, I couldn't avoid that. But like I said earlier, in real life, A crash would have cost me an airplane, possibly my life, my health. So I'm thankful that it's a sim, and I'm not gonna complain. I'm gonna take the cards I'm dealt and rely on my skills or lack thereof to get my my position a little bit better than where I'm at. Okay, I'm a little bit less than 5 seconds behind fourth, and that's really not good. Rein it back in, Scruff. Rein it back in. Spacegrass taking a really wide turn right there. Hopefully that will allow me to gain a little ground on them. I try to cut these pylons as short as I can to gain that little bit of advantage. Oh no, I actually lost some time there. So now I'm a little over 5 seconds.
End of lap two, keep it steady.
Still a little over 5 seconds behind. It's gonna be hard to make up 5 seconds, everybody. And that's just for fourth place, let alone, oh wow, I made up almost a second in two pylons. All right, we've got a 4 second. Oh yes, no doubt, I'll be doing more. Right now I'm just, because I'm so new at flight sim, I don't want to get into the jet racing or anything because I've never flown a jet yet. So I'm really happy and content with the speed of the T6, the T6 class. I know I'm not ready for unlimited. I know I'm not ready for jet. I surely know I'm not ready for biplane because I have seen very skilled pilots do horribly bad taking off with the biplanes. Yeah, so this is a class. It's the T6 class. It's not that I'm flying a T6. It's what they call the T6 class. I'm not sure what T6 stands for, but I just know it's the T6 class. Okay, so I'm 2.6 seconds behind fourth place now. Let's see if I can creep up on them. 2.7, so I've lost a tenth of a second right there. Let's get down low, not too low. See if I can cut this pylon really short. Spacegrass taking a really wide line there. I'm gonna try to take a short line and make up some time here. Okay, so that's 2 seconds now that I'm behind. 2.3 again. Down low.
Two laps left. Keep it up.
2.5. At least I'm keeping a consistent distance behind. 2.7. One 1.8. That's a good sign. Oh no, is that a pilot? Good gosh. Oh well. I just cost myself the race. That's okay. I'm not going to give up, but there's no way I'm making up 12 seconds. I cut it too short. Just trying to get that little bit of advantage. And now look how far behind I am just because of that. So I'm basically 15 seconds now behind, and I'm about to crash. Oh my gosh. I am totally blowing this race. Whew. I almost got a too high penalty too, an altitude penalty. Of course, Tomos. Yes. Yes, you can. Yeah, you need to sleep. You need to be able to sleep so that you can, so that you can race another day. You need to get your beauty sleep. Know what, it's not that I'm gonna throw the race or anything, but I'm really disappointed in myself for that penalty on the pylon. I was just getting so close, and then I got a little bit nervous because I was catching the fourth place person. Yeah, it's going to be last place for me, unfortunately. So it is what it is. I almost hit the ground right there. 6 seconds behind. And a disappointing finish for our second place finisher in the last race. Scruffy Tam with a disappointing last place finish, but no problem at all. He'll be back for the next race. All right, let's see here. Experience, absolute good job. No doubt I'm keeping my head up, Tomos. Thank you. Racing for Pinot Ware. All right, Tomos, you are going to go ahead and join. Dakey, would you like to join? Yeah, Dakey, I see that now. I see that you would like to. So yes, please. You're ready for T6, okay. Dakey, are you ready? You're trying to load in as well, okay. I'm going to go ahead and hit new race. I'll go ahead and start getting loaded in. And Tomos and Dakey, let's see if we can all be in the same race. This is really going to be fun. All right, here we go. I'm going to go ahead and select. All right, folks, here we go with another race. Racers, please report to the lobby and let's get another race in the books. We've got friends and fellow streamers, Scruffy Tam, Tomos World, and Dakey trying to get in. And they can have a little fun together in this race as well as compete. Let's see if they'll make it. Dakey's a beginner also. Race has been found. Let's see who's in here. We've got, yes, Dakey is in. We've got Sam's 257 in a SNJ for Big Red. We've got Gripper Sim in a AT6B Baron's Revenge. Dakey Decimus is in a T6 Texan. Tomos has now joined us. Switch 3900 into SNJ5 Radical Velocity. Scruffy Tam in his beautiful T6 Texan. DG Wallach in a T6 Texan. And Tomos in also a T6 Texan in the same livery as Dakey and DG Wallach. Here we go. Let's see if Scruffy Tam will overtake Tomos in this race.
Did you hear that sound?
Yeah, no doubt. Tomos will win this one. You only had time to press start? Wow, dude. Hey, at least he made it though. I'm glad we all made it in. This is going to be fun. maybe soon. Oh, and then someone else. So there's eight planes in this one. All right. Our audience, we have eight people in this race. Eight people. So here goes the qualification. This will be a one-lap qualifying round to find out what position each pilot will start in. Who will make first? Who will make second? Who will make third? Will it be a 1-2-3 Tomos, Dakey, and Scruffy Tam start? We'll find out shortly. Whew, here we go. If this crashes, I'm going to be so upset. It sure does seem to be taking a little while, but the screen does take its time. There we go. All right, folks, the pilots are in the air and they are coming up on the start finish line. Let's see where everyone's going to qualify. This should be fun. All right, here we go. Coming around the final corner to the start finish line. Here I come to the lap line. I've got a lot of turbulence. There we go. It's gone. Whatever was shaking my aircraft is gone now, so I'm happy about that. All right, here we go. Around the first pylon, Scruffy Tam goes. Second pylon in view. Bring it down, Scruff. Bring it down. Keep yourself together. Keep your airplane together as well. That's very important to keep your plane together at times like these.
Check your altitude. Get back
yes,
down now.
I'm too high. I'm down. All right. We are, I think we're doing fairly decent. That looked like a pretty nice line that I was flying. We'll see though. Only time will tell, right? We're just about halfway through this qualifying round. Coming up on the fourth pylon, fourth and fifth are rather close together. There's the fourth, here's the fifth. Level out just a little bit and then hit this one hard because the sixth one is a really tight turn from the fifth one. Really tight turn. There we go. Sixth pylon is here. You gotta be careful not to cut the seventh one too short. Seventh and the lap line. This is probably my best qualifying round yet. I'm gonna say that I'm probably not in last place at this point. Let's see how Scruffy Tam finished. Okay, Scruffy Tam made it into fifth place, but look at those times, everybody. Look at the times. They're all within 1 second of each other. All within 1 second. This is going to be a close race. We had one star did not qualify, but six people did qualify. And y'all, this is going to be a close race. So let's get this thing going. Line everybody up and get in the air. Yeah, this is going to be fun. Here we go. All right, people. Here we go. This should be interesting. I'm very pleased with how well I qualified. Very pleased. All right. Shake my nerves off. Shake off the nerves. Wipe off the hands. Focus on myself, not everybody else. Here we go, everybody. I'm gonna focus on flying my own aircraft. I'm not going to worry about the other opponents. Here we go. There's the lap line. Pylon 1 is in view. And let's get to racing.
Nice. You've got the inside track now. Let's keep it. We're in first place now.
Let's go. Really close. Oh, no. I hit someone else. Dang it. Who did I hit? Was it me and Dakey? I hit somebody. That That was really, really, really close. I think it was myself and Dakey collided with each other, unfortunately. Let's see how we're gonna do here. Holy crap, this is a really tight pack. Tomos in first place, unsurprisingly. Not surprised that Tomos is in first. Oh no, I almost hit the ground. Wait, what happened to Tomos? Tomos is no longer with us. Did Tomos crash? Or did the game glitch? Oh no. There is a chance for everybody else. Something happened with Tomos, our world champion. I hope Tomos is okay, and maybe they have an eject button in these aircraft and he was able to eject out. We might need emergency crews on the ground to check. And I'm being told that that emergency crews are on the ground to check and find out what is going on with Tomos, our world champion flyer, because it's very unusual that he's no longer with us. Dakey with the lead above Scruffy Tam, a little bit ahead of Scruffy, but Scruffy's gaining on Dakey. Dakey off to the right wing of Scruffy Tam. Whoa, Dakey, that was a really nice bank you did there. Really nice turn there on the fourth pylon to keep the lead in front of Scruffy. Switch, our leader, does have a pylon penalty, so that's gonna put Dakey and Scruffy Tam in a good place. So Dakey and Scruffy Tam have a real shot at first place because of the penalty, the pylon penalty. As long as they continue flying the way they're flying, they may finish one and two. Let's see. Only time will tell how this ends up. Dakey's got a really good flying line going on right now. Really, really well. Dakey, you're doing amazing. So Switch 3900 is going to have to overcome a 12-second penalty to pull off a win. Will they be able to do it? It would be extremely hard to... Not impossible, but it would be really hard at this point to overcome a 12-second penalty. We shall see, though. Time will tell. All right, so we're almost halfway through this race. Three laps out of the way. Oh, no. Tomos lost internet is what happened to Tomos. Tomos lost internet. Unfortunately, I was really, really looking forward to flying this entire race with Tomos. We have only flown one race together. But Tomos lost the internet, so he's fine. The emergency crew's checked. Everything's cool. He just lost comms on his plane, which kicked him from the competition, unfortunately. So Tomos survives to fly another day. And we are all glad of that. The audience is going wild. They're cheering that Tomos is okay. And we are also glad that our good friend and world champion flyer, Tomos, is fine. All right, here we go. Two more laps to go. We've got Dakey has taken the lead. Dakey has taken the lead from Switch. Oh no, and Scruffy is about to crash. Holy crap, that was close. Focus, Scruffy, focus. Get it back together, it's okay. You didn't crash? Get back online, get back in line. Oh no, what is going on? I'm getting overtaken. I made a mistake and now I'm getting overtaken. At least I won't be in last place. That's one thing, because Star has got two pylon penalties, so I'm not too concerned about Star unless they crash me. And then I'll be upset. Yeah, I know. I was doing so good about the altitude. I've just kind of lost my concentration once I got overtook there. Okay, so we got one final lap. One lap, and it's going to be close. It's pretty much anyone's race right now. White flag is out. Let's get it. Let's get it. Let's get it. There we go. Fourth pylon coming up. I'm still in fifth place. Still in fifth. I really, really badly want to at least get to third, which will give me a second place finish. But if I don't, it's fine. I'm very proud of the flying I've done in this race. I mean, my goodness, look how tight this pack is. I mean, it's extremely tight. So nothing to be ashamed of here. All right, well, and Scruffy Tam with a fifth place finish, but my goodness, what a race. Look at the times. Look at the times at how close the leaders were. Only 4 seconds separated everybody. CKB, from what I understand, no. And that's kind of what I was thinking, was maybe you could adjust mixture, but you can't. So yeah, all the planes are pretty much even. They're all the same. You had to bail. Oh no, dude. Oh, Dakey, yeah, that was really crappy. I was really looking forward to you winning. Oh, so I got fourth place? Oh yes, I did get fourth place, because one person had three penalties and then one had one. So instead of sixth, I ended up fourth. Dude, that was pretty awesome. So you ended up in third place, right, Dakey? Yes. All right. Dakey Decimus in third place. That put me in fourth. Oh, that was a lot of fun. So all that matters is your flight path. Yes. It's all about the skills. It's all about pilot skills. All the planes are supposed to be pretty much identical. Now, someone correct me if I'm wrong on that. But I'm pretty sure all the planes are identically built and it's all about pilot skill. All right, you want to do another race, Dakey? Tomos, you in for another one? That dropped me 5 places though in the rankings. I'm the one that took you out in the beginning. Dang, Dakey. See, I didn't know. I thought that was me and you that crashed. And I apologize for that. All right, let's do it. New race. Let's see if we can get in the same lobby again. That's a lot of fun. Also, anybody else that's in stream, that's in my stream, if you'd like to fly with us, let me know. Oh, good night, Tomos. Thank you so much. And let me give you one a parting shout out. A parting shout out to Tomos World. There we go. Check out Tomos if you don't already.
I would call and say to you,
have a break. Have a good cut.
I love it. Tomos loves his chocolate.
Choice of chocolate for tonight. No, you're not ready for this.
Okay, CKB. No problem at all. I really appreciate you just being here, so I totally get that. All right, we've got a race. Will Dakey be in this one? Let's find out. Dakey is in it, so we have so far 7 contestants. Switch, 3900 in an AT6A Gunslinger. Arrow, 7 in a T6G Undecided. Sam's, 257 in a SNJ 4 Big Red. Scruffy Tam in his beautiful T6 Texan. Mono Stripe Zebra in an AT6 Baby Boomer. Jakey Desmus in his T6 Texan. Armor Kill in their T6 Texan. And lastly, Habu 4813, also in a T6 Texan. Oh, thank you, CKB. I appreciate it. Thank you so much. Also, last race, it's the same time as Tomos has for you. That's right, it is. I forgot you guys are in the same time zone. But crazy Cosmic Bunny, thank you for the compliment. It is fun learning. I love learning new things. Even at the age of 53, I can still learn stuff. And y'all, I truly enjoy streaming. I truly enjoy my community. And I'm really, really loving Flight Sim, especially this race. This is a lot of fun. So thank you. All right, here we go. Qualifying is about to start. All right, everybody, qualifying starts now. We've got a full lobby of 8 racers. They'll make one lap around the track to determine position at the start of the race. Let's get this going. Here we go. Qualifying round. Gotta make this turn and find the number one pylon, and let's make a good line where I can have a good starting position. Here we go. We go around the first pylon. Let's keep it tight. Let's have a really tight qualifying field like we had last time. That was really an amazing race at how tight the qualifying was, and then at how close everyone's times were at the end of the race as well. Very, very impressive. All right, pylon 3. Here comes pylon 4. Scruffy is going to straighten his plane out for this one. Get really close to the ground. And then as we come up on the pylon, we'll start our turn and pull up slightly and keep the bank as we approach pylon 5. Let's try to keep a little bit of a bank. Keep our altitude low though. Oh my gosh, I'm gonna miss 5. Dang it. That totally screwed my lineup. Oh well. I'm probably gonna qualify last again. I totally blew that qualifying round. I cut way too. Judges will penalize you if you stay up there. Oh well. I got too high and way, way, way too wide. I had such a good qualifying going on too. Let's see how I placed. I bet I'm last. And Scruffy Tam really messing up on that last lap. However, he places 6th out of 7. But look at the spread of time in the field. First place with a 17, last place with a 24, or with a 53. So there's quite a spread of time here. This should be an interesting race. May not be as tight of a race as the last one that we witnessed. So here we go. We got one more pilot that has to qualify. Sam's 257 still needs to finish things up, and then we'll see. Oh, I'm so disappointed in myself. I don't think that that would have been a first place performance. By the way, congratulations, Dakey, on the first place. Qualifying in first. I don't think that would have been a first place qualifying, but it would have been top three probably had I not gone so high and so wide on pylon five. All right, folks, it is race time. Here we go. The pilots are heading to the start finish line. We'll start the countdown shortly. Exciting times. Let's see how tight the pack is for this one. And the race will start in, let's do the countdown. 3, 2, 1, let's race. All right, here we go. Let's get down low. Get tight. Low and tight. All right. Keep it turned a little bit. Keep it low. Keep it low. Keep it low. All right, here we go. Turn. Let's keep it tight. Where's that third pylon? We're going to go ahead and keep our turn going. Go low. Come up and get ready, lined up for the fourth pylon. I can't believe that I'm still in sixth place. I thought I was doing pretty good, but apparently not. There are eight pilots in this one. This is going to be Crash City if we get tight. So hopefully there won't be a lot of crashing going on, but there's that potential with this many pilots. We shall see. We shall see. All right, here we go. Fifth pylon. I'm going high again. Let's not go too wide. Let's get back down. Turn tight. That sixth pylon. Oh my gosh, I collided with another aircraft again. All right, it's okay. It's okay. I'm going to keep it tight. Let's not get a pylon penalty. I've got plenty of time to make up for that mistake. We're going to go low. I've got a ton of wake turbulence going on from all these seven other aircraft in front of me. I'm going to go really low. Let's pull tight. Pull tight. Find the second pylon. Oh, no. No, 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 no. Mistakes have been made once again, people. It's okay. Let's find the third pylon. We can always make this up. There's plenty of time to make up for this mistake. All right. There's the third pylon. At least I'm not in last. We've got one person who's got a pylon penalty. So technically, I'm in sixth place right now. I need to get low. Make some dust. Oh no, not that low. And let's go ahead and start this turn for the fourth pylon. Boom. All right. The fifth pylon isn't so bad, but the sixth one, it's a super tight turn. Really tight turn right here to the sixth pylon. And I pulled that one off. Let's keep it tight. Let's keep it tight. Seventh pylon coming up. Coming up on the lap line. Still in seventh place. I am not believing that I'm still in seventh. I thought I was flying pretty good.
Two down, starting lap three.
All right, here we go. Still plenty of time to make up. Plenty of time to make up for that crash. And I've got to watch for the other pilot so I don't have another crash. Here we go. Pylon three coming up. Keep a tight line. Look for four pylon. There it is. Let's get low. Let's get fast. Number four pylon. Right here. Start our bank. Pull up slightly so we don't hit the ground. There we go. There we go. There we go. Don't hit the ground. Perfect. Perfect. That was really nice. Really nice. Don't get a pylon penalty. I went too wide and I'm going too high again. That's costing me. That is costing me. Yep. I was catching Habu, and that cost me some time. It's okay. I'm 1.7 seconds behind. Now I'm pretty much two seconds behind Habu.
3 laps remaining. Show them what you got.
All right, here we go. Let's make this one as flawless a lap as I have ever done. No, don't get a pylon penalty. There we go. Gosh, that was close. Really, really close. All right, here we go. Let's go to pylon four. We've got time. We've got time. I don't need to crash, though. Let's turn hard. Pull up just slightly. Turn hard to the fifth pylon. Fifth pylon's here. Keep the turn. Keep the turn. Keep the turn. So we can make the sixth easily. There we go. Was that? Dang it, I cut the pylon. I am easily in seventh place now for sure. Oh well. Mistakes were made. I was so close to making it. Now I'm in sixth place. I have overtaken Habu. If I can keep that up, at least I'll have a seventh place finish, because I just got a 12 second penalty, unfortunately. And Habu is out of the race. I wonder what happened to Habu. They quit. Something happened. We may have to send the emergency crews out to find out what happened to Habu this time. All right, here we come up on the fourth pylon. One more lap to go. Will Scruffy be able to make up for the mistakes that he has made in the earlier part of the race? We shall see. We shall see. All right, here we go. We're going to try to keep a nice line. Don't cut five this time. Nice, nice, nice. All right, we're tight on six. We're tight on six. That's nice. Let's keep the turn going. I'm almost 6 seconds behind the fifth place person, though, so got a lot of making up to do here if I'm gonna place better than what I am right now. All right, white flag, last lap. Last lap. Let's keep it tight. Let's keep it low. 5.5 seconds behind Switch 3900. Stay low, stay low. We can still catch him. It's just going to take one mistake. And I see that Mono Stripe Zebra has made some mistakes. And so that will put us ahead of Mono Stripe Zebra, bringing us up in position, thankfully. So yeah, we're actually looking pretty good. There have been two pylon cuts now, from two different players. So that looks really well. That's going to bode well for me. There we go. So I will not overtake Switch 3900, but I will finish in fifth place, because Mono Stripe Zebra and Aero 7 have cut two pylons, costing them 24 seconds each. There we go. Boom. How about that crash landing right at the end? All right, and Scruffy Tam. Wait a minute, how did I finish in sixth? How did I end up with a sixth place finish? I call shenanigans on that, because I thought two other players had done two pylon cuts and that would cost them 12 seconds each. And I know I wasn't 12 seconds behind, but anyways, so there we go. I'm Scruffy Tam finishing in fourth place, a solid fourth place finish. Not too shabby. Could have done better, but not too shabby. You don't like ramming. You don't like the ramming. Last corners, nobody cares, and just rams. What do you mean by ramming, Dakey? Because I might be doing that. I'm not sure what ramming is. Oh, you mean like just hitting? You mean hitting the other pilots? Solid second though, Dakey. No, I know I didn't hit you, but it's hard for me at that speed and being a new pilot too to be able to watch out for the other pilots and be able to miss them when we're flying so in such a tight, you know, such tight quarters. But yeah, I mean that probably is happening some on purpose. But thank you for flying in that race as well. I'm actually, let's see here. Let's go to next. I want to see the world rankings again. That bloke that cut the corners came closer and just parked right into your plane. Oh man. And see, when they're already going to lose, I mean, it's just not right of them. You know, if you've already cut two pylons, don't try to take someone out that's in the lead. All right, I'm not going to do another race right this minute. I'm going to look and see. Let's look at the world leaderboard and see where Tomo stands. Nice. How did I guess I missed that. I must have missed that. Does it show you that? Oh, sweet. Wow. All right, let's look at the leaderboards. I may do some time trials just to practice without hurting myself with my score. Oh no, Tomos has dropped down to ninth place. Tomos is in ninth now. I hope Tomos is sleeping and did not hear me say that. All right, yeah, I think I'm going to do some time trials now just to familiarize myself a little bit more with, you know, the line, getting a good line and stuff. So I'm going to take a quick bathroom break. Give me no more than 5 minutes and I'll be right back. If 5 minutes, probably not even five, but I'll be right back. Enjoy some music from Rhetorical Owl, also known as Toma's World. I'll be right back. All right, I'm back. So I've decided I'm gonna do some time trials just to familiarize myself with the controls a little bit better and just get some practice in without it affecting my points, my Reno points. And then I may end up also going to my coast-to-coast U.S. tour, because I do need to, I do want to finish up my coast-to-coast U.S. tour as well. So for the next little while, I'm going to do some time trials first, work on my flying line and see how I do with that. Maybe do some experimenting. Okay, so this really is a T6. I wasn't sure that there was a such thing as a T6 aircraft, but there is. It's a T6 Texan, okay. Good information here, good information. You're about to do the night shift on your Zara World Tour, but live weather in Russia was not loading in, so you had to cancel. Oh, dang. What? All right, I'm going to go ahead and select this. Let's see. Oh, so you're still somewhat competing against other players in the time trials as well, but that's okay. I'm not looking to get up here at the top, but my goodness, what a time there. Just under 6 seconds lead. What? Here we go. Let's see what this is about. Yeah, I was waiting a whole week, waiting for a gap in the weather, but now the sim weather was bugged. Dang, that's totally crappy. Okay. All right. Got a one pylon out of the way. Let's go for a two pylon. I am too high. Yeah, I definitely don't want to be penalized. All right. Number two pylon. Let's get low. Oh, so it does take six laps too. I didn't realize that it was still six laps. I thought it was just going to be a one lap thing. So that's good. Give you time to warm up. Go pylon 5, we're gonna cut it really close, and then let's zoom on over here to pylon 6. Let's get back low, get ready for the turn. Oh no, I have shut my engine down. Oh well, I was playing with the fuel mixture and I just sabotaged myself. So a not so successful first time trial. There we go. Oh my gosh, this is gonna be awful. My engine is still off. Okay, so I don't know what to do. I guess I can just land. I guess I'll just land and shut the engine off. I have no idea. I may just have to exit out. This is really weird. Yeah, this I'm just gonna have to exit out. Wow, that was strange. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna I think I'm done with racing for now. Oh no, I hit the wrong thing. I didn't mean to hit that. I'm gonna go back to the main menu this time, and I'll just continue my coast to coast US tour. Let's see what the next flight is. Oh my gosh, that was a huge fail. Let me get my little nav map pulled up. Okay, so we'll start at Storm Lake Municipal, and it's a 163 nautical miles to what airport is this going to be? Okay, Minneapolis, St. Paul, Minnesota. So from Iowa to Minnesota. Iowa to Minnesota, and let's go ahead and dial in. So I definitely don't want to do live weather. How can I change that? I guess I have to dial in the runway first. Okay, here we go. So the departure aircraft. You're signing off for tonight. Thank you so much, Dakey. I appreciate that. Thank you for the races, too. That was a lot of fun. I have thoroughly enjoyed racing. So thank you so much for joining me for those few races. And I will see you soon on one of your streams, or you on mine again. And thank you again. I appreciate that. Have a good night, my friend. Sleep well. All right, here we go. Storm Lake. Okay, I've got a issue with the weather. Taco, what is going on? Taco, show us those socks. All right, my socks of the day. Since you threw that command out there, Taco, my socks of the day. Oh my gosh, my legs are showing. I am so sorry. I need to pull those things up. Socks of the day on the right foot. I've got my black and white striped socks. On the left foot are my light blue with pink cactuses. Those are my socks of the day. Oh my gosh. What has happened to my camera? I'm sorry, you're going to have nightmares after that. So, I've got to figure out how to change this from... Oh, your Steam is doing the same thing mine was? What? Wow, well, I'm glad to know it's not just mine, that it's not an internet issue, that it's a Steam issue. So that's... I mean, it's unfortunate, but I'm glad to know that it's not just... my internet. All right, I need to change. I need to look at these options. Steam has been down as well yesterday. Oh, really? Steam was down? General options. Where is live weather at? Traffic. Land and sea. Data miscellaneous? Wait a minute, data. Live weather on. VR mode I don't want. Controls, controls is definitely not what I want. Assistance maybe? Trying to make it where I can change the weather or change the time anyways. I'm not really worried about changing the weather. I'm wanting to change the time. Because I don't like flying night flights. But if I can't change it, it'll be okay. And by the way, I've got 55 hours now in this game. 55 hours. All right, let's go to the world map. Don't know why I can't change live. There we go. Okay. Weather and time. So I'll go with all players. Excuse me. We change it to where we have some daylight here. There we go. And we'll take off from, this is a really small airport. I'm gonna take off, I'll start right here. Set as the departure. Let's go ahead and get ready. So this should be a rather short flight. It is 163 nautical miles to our final destination of Minneapolis St. Paul Airport in Minnesota, United States. Let's get it loaded in. Here we are. Got the aircraft already running. Not sure why we're not hearing it. Oh, that's why. You gotta hit ready to fly first. All right, get my feet on my rudder pedals and let's go. Let's get this this plane off the ground. We got Mr. Tyler 12 right here in front of us, flying at 35,000 feet, so no problems there with interference. And we have liftoff. So Taco, the really good thing about flight sim is that there are tutorials in the game that teach you how to fly initially. It's really, really interesting to learn the mechanics of flying. I highly recommend it to anybody. You got a bad memory. I understand that. I can get that. But I would really highly recommend this to anybody, especially if you have any interest at all in flight and flying, and I do, then it's really amazing. So I need to go to a heading of 32. All right, turn on headings. Let's turn on vertical speed and I will go up at 500 feet a minute. Bring my RPM down a little bit. I did forget to fill our fuel tanks this time, but that's okay. And I think I'm gonna go with a rather low altitude flight as well. You can see that we're getting into some clouds. I'm probably gonna stick with right where I'm at right now. So let me go ahead and get this leveled out. Oops. There we go. So now we're flying at a cruising altitude of just under 4,000 feet. Looks like we're gonna have some clouds. That's okay. Go ahead and make an announcement to our passengers.
And welcome back, passengers. This is your Captain Scruffy Tam speaking. We have just reached our cruising altitude of 3,810 feet. This is where we'll stay for the remainder of the flight. We are running into a little bit of a weather system, so we'll probably have some turbulence. So I'm going to ask that everyone stay seated. And when you are seated, please just keep your seatbelt buckled for your safety. Also, keep all carry-on items stowed in the compartment ahead of you or above you, or in the seat ahead of you. Should be a rather short flight, so enjoy the flight. The flight attendants will be by with some light refreshments, courtesy of Scruffy Tam Airlines. Thank you again for flying with us. Hope you enjoy your flight, and I'll be back with you when we get closer to Minneapolis, St. Paul.
All right. I need to save that setting. Let me go into my GoXLR settings and save this, because I had it dialed in really nice this afternoon, the pilot voice, and then I forgot to save it. So give me just a second. There we go. I had to save everything like I like it when I first turned my GoXLR on, and that is music, you know, at a loud level for when I'm just starting stream. My microphone off, and then the PC sounds also loud as well. So I wanted to, so I turned the music on for a minute so I could get all the levels adjusted like I like them. So Taco, did you have a good day? What did you do today? Because for you, it's gotta be at least midnight, right? I mean, it's definitely late at night for you, or early in the morning. No, it's 2 or 3 in the morning for you, Taco, is that right? Go to external view. Take a look around out here. It's like a pretty strong storm going right there. Look, you can even see the rain. Or is that just another cloud? You know what? That's more clouds. I thought that was the rain pouring down. Got several other simmers flying around us here. Hopefully it'll be a rather uneventful flight. Got a looks like a storm system brewing right here, a rather tall columbus. I forgot how you say that, but cloud right there building, as well as some over here, but we are far enough to the left of it where I don't think it will affect us. I'll just stick with the external view for just a little bit. Kind of enjoy this view. This Darth Doozler. Enjoying a nice little quiet chill flight tonight. I will be ending stream after we reach our final destination, which will still be a little while, probably about an hour. This flight will be, and then I'll want to wrap things up, go to bed at a little bit more decent time than what I did yesterday, last night. There. Trying to adjust my camera a little bit. Put me more in the center of it. You can see the other flight sim players right now, and there are a good many. There are a good many of them. I wonder if they're all flying together as a group, or if there just happens to be this many people that are flying in the same area, because I do know that a lot of streamers, and myself included, will allow viewers to join them on these flights. So I just wonder if that's what's happening here. We're hanging in right at 3,930 feet right now, holding steady. Oh no, Taco, that's fine. That's fine. Typically Saturday nights are pretty slow for me anyways on my streams. They're pretty slow. So no, I'm not concerned about it. I'm just enjoying the flight. No worries at all, friend. Appreciate you being here. I wonder how far away these other simmers are from us. I may, you know what, I think I am. I'm gonna go ahead and get the drone back out. So drone speed, I'll make it where it's fairly fast.
Hello, is it
Swan? Hey Swan. Swan, thank you so much for the lurk. I appreciate you being here. Alright, let's go check out, see if we can find these other flight simmers. Which one's closest to us? It gets really quiet once you fly away. My goodness, they must be a long ways away. I wonder, is there a way that I can adjust? Oh, good Lord. And I have lost. I guess I can get back to the plane just by changing the camera view, though. I was about to say I've lost my aircraft. I have no idea where I'm at. Oh, this is funny. Lost drone stream, anybody? Uh-oh. I'm hearing something that doesn't sound very good. Okay. Thankfully, it was not my plane. I don't know what that was I was hearing, but it didn't sound very good, so I figured I'd come back to this view. We are coming up on this weather system. So I think I'm gonna put my drone back up. I'll have to play with that another time when I have some time to really play around with it and learn it. Since we got this weather system we're coming up on, I guess I need to tell my passengers that we've got some potential rough turbulence coming up. Let me go ahead and jump back to cockpit view.
Passengers, this is your Captain Scruffy Tam. Your Captain Scruffy from Scruffy Tam Airlines. Back with you again. We are about to be flying through a rather rough storm system. So once again, I'll just remind you the seatbelt light sign is on. Be sure that you keep your seatbelt securely fastened. And once we're out of the storm, I'll turn the seatbelt light back off and then you can feel free to move around. But it looks like these storms are going to be with us for a little while. So sit back, enjoy the flight. We may try to fly. Yeah, there you go. We may try to fly above this system in just momentarily.
Okay, I may go ahead and do that. Just try to fly above it because flying through storms is not a whole lot to see. Let's see if I can just climb over it. So I've got it set to increase altitude at a pretty rapid pace, so I'm gonna have to watch my airspeed. My airspeed is declining. Not really rapidly. Actually, it's not as fast as I thought it would be as far as the airspeed decline. So I may move this up a little bit more. See if we can just pull above this storm. We're getting close to the speed where I might want to slow down my ascent a little bit, but we're holding pretty steady. I'm really surprised at how well it's doing. So I'll just leave that set like it is. Let's look outside. Holy crap. These are some really dark clouds, everybody. I don't even want to look. Trying to climb above them. All right, so we're at 6,500 feet now. Got plenty of altitude in this aircraft. I mean, we can climb pretty high in this one and not really have any worries. So we'll just keep our ascent going. As long as my airspeed doesn't drop too low, then we'll be safe. And it is slowly dropping. Tan the OG, hey babe. Hello, mate. Hey, Tam the OG. I hope you're doing well. I had to stop the races. It was getting pretty intense. And I wanted to do some practicing, and I kind of blew the practice too, so I figured I'd just go with my regular old flights for now. So we're going to Minneapolis, St. Paul, Minnesota. We're on our way there. And then from there on my next flight, Tam the OG, after tonight is going to take us to Green Bay, Wisconsin, and then from there I'll be going to O'Hare. Chicago O'Hare. So in two more streams we should be flying to Chicago. All right, that pulled us above the storm. I'm gonna go ahead and slow my ascent down a little bit. I'm still gonna keep on gaining altitude, but just not at as rapid a pace as what I was. So we'll try to level out a little bit and see what goes on. Yeah, so not now. In two more streams, one or two more streams, we'll be going to O'Hare Airport. Getting back close to home, Tam, and then once I finish the coast to coast tour, then I'll be down for some world stuff, like checking out some sights and scenery around the world.
All right, passengers, this is Scruffy, your pilot again with Scruffy Tam Airlines. I was able to get us above that weather system, so hopefully that will cut back on the turbulence that we're going to run into. But there's still a possibility for turbulence, so I'm going to keep that seatbelt fastened light on still until we get beyond this weather system entirely. So, again, keep your seatbelt buckled. Let's stay safe and enjoy the rest of your flight. I'll be back in touch shortly.
Alrighty. So, still got a little ways to go. Not quite. Well, we're probably one third of the way done with our flight for tonight. And then once we land in Minneapolis, I'll be in wrapping things up. I'm going to try to get in bed a little bit earlier this evening than what I did yesterday. And I'm wondering if there's a way that I can turn off the seeing all these other players. I mean, I'm cool with seeing other players, but I had no idea it was going to be this many people. Wait, Mithar. No Mithar available. Okay. Ooh, also, wait a minute. So 2020. So 2021. Today is the 20th. When was the lunar eclipse? That wasn't last night, which was the 19th. So it was the 18th. And let's go. There it is. There it is. Heck yes. This is what I was wanting to do, and I want to get rid of all the other people. How do I get rid of their names? Objectives. I'm not worried about objectives. I want to know if I go to external view, it will still show them, if I'm not mistaken, right? Correct. So I want to make it. We go into settings and let's see here. Controls, general assistance. I think it's general. traffic. Turn off the nameplates. Apply and save. Let's go back and then resume. Yes, that's what I'm looking for. And now... now what I want to do, now that I've got the full moon, is I just want to get some shots, some screenshots of the full moon, but then change the time to where it is the blood moon that's showing. So we actually see the eclipse. Uh-oh, wait a minute. Where'd you go, moon? Where did you go? There it is. Trying to find the moon. So it really was yesterday morning then, wasn't it? There we go. Okay, now there's the moon tracking. We're gonna have clouds. Dang it. That's okay. All right, I'm going to change my heading. My aircraft heading to a heading where I'll be facing the camera. So if I go 32, let's go 90. And then go to external view again. And then hopefully we'll be facing this direction. Yes, this is what I was wanting. Yes, yes, everybody, we're posing with the moon. Okay, now let me go back to live weather. I do want to do real time this time. Oh no, I didn't mean to do real time, but that's okay. Real time is just rough because you really can't see. Oh shoot, I gotta get back on track too. You really can't see anything at night unless you're flying over a pretty big city. All right, we're back to cockpit view. Let's change the heading back to a 32. Let's go with a 30. Let's go with a 30.
Hello, is it me you're looking for?
Swan, thank you, thank you, thank you. I appreciate that. Yeah, it's a lot of fun that you can do that. It's something that I had been wanting to do, is get some shots with the blood moon. So there we go. I was able to get it. And I'm going to change the time to a more... to a time where we can see a little bit better there. That's what I was trying to say. I was trying to concentrate on changing things around. This is beautiful. get some screenshots for my Instagram page. Oh, so we got the moon on our left and the sun to our right. And it's funny because the other day, Sissy Cat, my granddaughter, was in the vehicle with me. And I said, look, y'all, you can see the moon on one side and the sun on the other. And she said, Pop Pop, you're just kidding me. There's no way that you can see the sun and the moon at the same time. And the sun had set far enough down where I couldn't say, well, look, there it is. Yeah. But I think she finally knew I wasn't playing around. Change my heading a little bit more just to get me lined up with the airport where I need to be. Beautiful sunrise happening right now. Oh my gosh, we're at 14,000 feet too. I forgot that I had it still climbing in altitude, so I think I can probably slow that down a little bit now. There we go. Let's get this airspeed back up. My goodness, I'm glad I happened to think to look at that. And I also need to adjust, switch tanks too. Switch fuel tanks. And I'm gonna adjust my vertical speed down just a little bit now. My pizza heat I need to turn on as well. Making all the mistakes tonight, y'all. There we go. Which is a typical scruffy tam stream. Is making some mistakes on the flight sim. Aren't you all glad that this is just a flight sim and not a real flight? And I think I'm going to go ahead and find an airport that's closer for us to go ahead and land at. Is it not that it's really late for me, but I'm really tired. I've had a busy, busy day. We decorated for Christmas earlier today. Had the grandkids for a little while. I did do a 4-hour stream early this morning. I got up and went ahead and did a 4-hour stream. So I think I'm going to go ahead and descend and find a little airport to go ahead and land at. So let me get down to a decent altitude. And I'm going to go ahead and wrap things up. Look at our airspeed. We're going really fast. We're descending at a pretty fast rate too. I want to see what this looks like. Okay, not too off the bed. We'll push the airframe to its limits here. right, so now we're getting close to breaking our airframe at 180 knots. That's pretty freaking fast. I don't want to crash us. But I was just curious as to what the limit, you know, how fast of an how fast of a descent I could do here. It looks like I can hit 200 miles an hour or 200 knots. We are really, really going fast. Going down fast. Let's see what this looks like, and then I'm gonna, oh wow, okay. I need to adjust this because we're getting close to braking speed. And there we go. We're safe. We're safe. Fixing to break through the clouds as we ascend. I may try. There's an airport up here to the left. I may try to land at. We'll see. Excuse me. I still need to ascend rather quickly to make it to that one. It's let's see what it's at 1,017 feet, so I've still got a little ways to go before we're in any danger of hitting anything. You got me, Hannah. You got me that time. I was like, what the heck? How are you doing? Welcome. Good evening to you, Hannah. I hope you had a wonderful day. I hope you had a good day. I'm just kind of playing around, not really doing much of anything right now. I found an airport. I'm going to go ahead and land and just call it a night. It's been a long day for me. But I hope you're doing well. I hope you're doing well. Tell me about your Saturday. All right, I'm about to take manual control now. I'm gonna knock autopilot off. Autopilot is now off. And I'm gonna keep my descent going, but not at quite a fast rate. You went to a birthday party for your grandma. Oh, how old is your grandma, Anna? All right, we're coming up to our new destination. Yeah, I got my. Oh wow, she just turned 83. Dang. Hey, that's good. I'm glad that she's still that she still has her wits about her. All right, so we're at 1,000 feet above the ground, pretty much. I'm gonna stay this way for now. I'm gonna come up on the final approach here to Mankato Regional. Mankato Regional Airport is located in Minnesota, Mankato, Minnesota. So we're just stopping a little bit short of our final destination of Minneapolis, Minnesota. We'll just stop in at Mankato. I have been to Minneapolis, Minnesota one time. Go ahead and slowly turn that direction. I'm looking for the runway on in real life. Well, not in real life, but looking for the runway in the game. See where those lights are blinking, so I'll know where I need to come in to land. Should be seeing it soon. We're about 20 or so miles out from the airport. The Reno Air Races have worn me out. So we'll blame ending my stream earlier than I had planned to on air racing. I should be seeing those runway lights really soon. I see them. Today has been a really good day for our stream. We've made some new friends. I've gained some new followers, met a new flight sim streamer who spent some time at the beginning of my stream in the channel. From Australia, if I'm not mistaken. And then they had to run because it was really late for them. But it's always cool making new friends, especially when you have the same interests in mind. So I'm very, very thankful that she was able to join us. Hey, Silverspell, how are you? Good evening, friend. Stream is good. It's kind of slow tonight, which typically Saturday night streams are usually slow. So yeah, I'm fixing to go ahead and land and end stream tonight. It's been a really good day. I had an amazing stream this morning. Really nice. Made some new friends. Learned a new skill, airplane racing. But how are you, Silverspell? Good to see you. And actually, the new streamer that I met is from, I'm pretty sure they're from Australia. I'm not sure what part of Australia, but I'm pretty sure they're from your part of the world. Oh no, that's fine, Hannah. I totally get, I mean, there's real life. Oh, you're dealing with a tantruming toddler. I remember those days. Hannah, one thing I don't ever want to do to my mods is have them feel like they always have to be in my stream. So I don't want you to feel you know, that pressure. And my goodness, I truly appreciate what you do, and I know that it's not a real life job. It doesn't pay a whole lot. But I just appreciate your willingness to do that, Hannah. Thank you. So never feel bad about not being here. I keep on seeing the runway and then losing the runway. It's really weird. I'll see the runway lights and then they go away. I'll see them and then they go away. And I was hoping it wasn't because I was flying over the runway, and it's not. We should be getting really rather close though. I just realized that I need to change my my fuel mixture. I was running really, really very little fuel, and my airspeed was getting pretty low. So I've picked it up a little bit now. So we'll get there a little bit quicker, and hopefully we won't fall out of the sky for lack of airlift. They have turned off the runway lights, apparently. They probably, if I was to contact the air traffic control, they would probably want me to fly into a different runway than the one I'm about to land on. Oh, I see the runway lights again. There we go. They're right to the left of this pond that I'm coming up on. Just to the left of it. So I'm gonna try to get lined up here. Bring my engine RPMs, change my prop pitch. Keep my RPMs up for now. Coming in at a little bit of an angle, but that's okay. He's tantruming because, oh good Lord. Silverspell, why wouldn't you let your toddler do what they want to do and run in a road with traffic, right? It's so funny the things that kids will have a tantrum over. And you try to tell them it's for your own good and they don't believe you. But then one day when they're older and you tell them that, they're like, dang, mom, did I really do that? All right, here we go. Coming in, I'm gonna bring my prop pitch back a little bit more. I do need to get lined up a little bit better with this runway. Holy crap. Yes, Hannah. The kind of a really small streamer, please. But yeah. Since my numbers are down, I don't want to raid a, you know, like a really big streamer or anything. No, but yeah, please. Oh, thank you for shouting out, Silver Spell.
It's fucking fine. Just go for it. I am on second hook, but like, it's not worth it, Elmo.
Elmo, just.
I mean, the hatch is right there.
Oh, good night. This is a horrible landing. I thought I was. Oh, good night. I thought I was gonna do good. And I ended up crashing.
Go.
Yes, Elmo.
Fuck you, bitch. Fuck you.
All right, there we go. Does the game matter? No. The game doesn't matter. It does not. All right, I crashed, and we're going to go ahead and end. That was a horrible landing, my worst in quite a while.